Hi everybody, this slide we will introduce you about the mature product that's involved the chemical reaction. Before we talk about the mature product involved chemical reaction, we would like to introduce you about some important terms that we incorporate in the chemical balance. Chemical reaction, mass balance in chemical reaction system. The third term we will talk about the stoichiometry. Stoichiometry is the theory of theory of the proportion in which chemical species combined with is another side. The stoichiometric equation is a chemical reaction with statement of relative number of molecules, hormone of weight 10, and product that participate in the reaction. Like this example, I show you the stoichiometric equation. This is right. For this case, we know that every two molecules hormones of sulfur dioxide that react one mole or one molecule of oxygen react to produce two moles of sulfur trioxide, two moles or two molecules of sulfur trioxide. Right? The number two, number one, number two, that's right, that precedes the formula for each species and the stoichiometric coefficient. Stoichiometric coefficient, that's right, two. Stoichiometric coefficient for sulfur dioxide is two. Stoichiometric coefficient for oxygen is 1 and 2 for sulfur trioxide. For product, we have a positive value and reactant is negative. That means plus 2 for sulfur trioxide, minus 1 for oxygen, and minus 2 for sulfur dioxide. This is the stoichiometric coefficient. Right? For this case, a very stoichiometric coefficient must be balanced. Stoichiometric equation must be balanced, that is number of atoms of each atomic species must be the same what size. Because this is in the atoms can need to be created, you know, destroyed in chemical reaction. For example, if we consider a sulfur dioxide react with a half of oxygen produce 1 mole of sulfur dioxide. So this form 1 mole sulfur dioxide react with a half mole of oxygen produce 1 mole of sulfur trioxide. If we consider atomic sulfur, that's right. The left hand side is one atomic sulfur. Right hand side is one atomic sulfur. For oxygen, the left hand side is two oxygen plus this is two multiplied by a half, we get one. That's two plus one equal to three oxygen. The right hand side is also three oxygen. If we consider this reaction, right? Two sulfur dioxide react with 1 mole oxygen produce 2 mole sulfur trioxide. As I did, 2 sulfur and 2 sulfur. Left hand side, 2 oxygen, 2 multiplied by 2, we get 4 oxygen. Plus 2 oxygen, we get 6 oxygen. Right hand side, 3 oxygen multiplied by 2, we get 6 oxygen. This is balance. Right? Sulfur left hand side equal to sulfur right hand side. Oxygen left hand side equal to oxygen right hand side, right? Okay. Before you do the material balance on chemical reaction, you have to balance atomic balance of the stoichiometric equation also. Okay. The next term we talk about the stoichiometric ratio of the two molecule species that's participating in a reaction. It's the ratio of stoichiometric coefficient in the balance reaction equation. It should be the stoichiometric coefficient ratio of the balanced reaction. If reaction is not balanced, you have to balance first and then calculate the ratio. Sometimes we can use this ratio to be the conversion factor. You can use to calculate amount of particular reactant or product. That's what consume or produce. Right? For example, if you consider like this reaction 2 mole of sulfur dioxide. React with 1 mole of oxygen and then produce 2 mole of sulfur trioxide. This is balanced already. Okay, if you consider the ratio of sulfur trioxide and oxygen, from the equation you get 2 mole of sulfur trioxide. This product should be generated divided 1 mole of oxygen consumed. And also, if you consider the ratio of SO2 for SO3, SO2 is reactant should be 2 mole or 2 power mole, 2 kilomole, you can use each other. For this case, it's 2 power mole SO2 consumed because SO2 is reactant per 2 power mole of sulfur trioxide generated, for example, right? Okay, if you know the amount of folate, mass folate of sulfur trioxide, for example, right, 16,000 kilograms per hour of sulfur trioxide, it should be produced, and then you can calculate amount of oxygen required, something like based on the ratio. Because the ratio should be the mole ratio, because the stoichiometric coefficient is the number of mole, not mass, right? If for this case, you have to convert mass of sulfur trioxide is produced to be mole of sulfur trioxide produced. That's right. You know, 16,000 kilograms sulfur trioxide generated per hour. You divide this by molecular weight of sulfur trioxide. It's 80 kilograms sulfur trioxide per 1 kilomole sulfur trioxide. From the stoichiometric ratio, right? Stoichiometric ratio of sulfur trioxide and oxygen. We know that 2 mole or 2 kilomole sulfur trioxide generated equal to 1 kilomole oxygen consumed. That you can calculate mole of oxygen consumed or oxygen required, right? Sulfur trioxide. Sulfur oxide, so you get kilomole oxygen per hour. And then you can convert mole oxygen to mass oxygen by multiply by molecular weight of oxygen. Get this answer, right? The next term we talk about the limiting and excess reactant. Assume we have two reactants A and B are said to be present in the stoichiometric quotient. If the ratio mole A present per mole B present equal to the stoichiometric and from the equation. Okay. For this example, right, 2 mole sulfur dioxide react with 1 mole oxygen, we get 2 mole sulfur trioxide. That means the stoichiometric ratio of sulfur dioxide per oxygen is 2 per 1. That's right, 2 mole sulfur dioxide, 1 mole oxygen. This is stoichiometric ratio of 1 sulfur trioxide. Oxygen. Okay, if we feed the reactant to a chemical reactor in stoichiometric proportion, right, and the reactant proceeds to completion, right, to completion, right, it means all reactants are consumed. For example, right, 200 mole SO2 and 100 mole of oxygen are fed. Okay, what is the limiting reactant? The limiting reactant is the reactant that generates the reactant that consume out or run out. First, if we can proceed completion, and the other reactant are termed as excess. Right? If we have one reactant that consume out first, we call that is the limiting reactant, and another one we call this the excess limiting reactant. Excess reactant. For example, right, if we have 100 mole oxygen and less than 200 mole of sulfur dioxide are free. This means we can sulfur dioxide is limiting reactant. Why we call this? Because the reactant is limit because it present less than its stoichiometric proportion relative to the other reactant. But that means from the stoichiometric ratio is 2 per 1. Right? 2 mole sulfur dioxide, 1 mole oxygen. But in the feed, we feed 1 mole oxygen, but less than 2 mole sulfur dioxide. That's right, because it's 100 per 200 is also 1 per 2. That's right. For this case, we feed 100 oxygen, less than 200 mole of sulfur dioxide. That means we feed less than the stoichiometric ratio. Okay, this is, we can conclude that the limiting reactant is sulfur dioxide. We can talk to you this later for the example. If you know the limiting reactant, and then you know the limiting reactant, then you know the limit, excess reactants. And then you can calculate fractional excess. Fractional excess of the reactant A is the mole of feed A. Right? And that's mole of feed A, mole of A that required due to the stoichiometric ratio. What is the mole of A that's required due to the stoichiometric ratio? And then you can calculate percent excess by multiply this equation with 100. Okay. For example, if you consider acetylene react 1 mole acetylene react 2 mole hydrogen to produce 1 mole ethane. Right, 1 mole ethane. For this case, we feed 20 kilomole per hour of acetylene, 50 kilomole per hour of hydrogen are fed to the reactor. And then from the story, we know that the ratio of hydrogen to acetylene is 2 per 1, that's right, 2 mole hydrogen, 1 mole acetylene. This is the stoichiometric ratio. But for the feed ratio, that's right, the feed ratio is 50 kilomole hydrogen, right, per 20 kilomole oxygen. This is 2.5 per 1, that's right, 2.5 per 1. And for this case, you can see that the ratio is greater than stoichiometric stoichiometry. That means hydrogen should be excess reactant and acetylene should be limiting reactant. That's right, for this case. Or you can write the ratio of acetylene per ratio of hydrogen. It is 1 divided by 2. And this is 1 divided by 2.5. That means the ratio of acetylene is less than limiting and less than stoichiometric because this is the limiting reactant also. For this case, because the ratio of hydrogen to acetylene is greater than the ratio in the stoichiometric, that means hydrogen is the excess and acetylene is the limiting reactants. Yes. And then you can calculate fractional excess. Fractional excess is the mole of hydrogen in the feed. Hydrogen in the feed is 50. 50, that's right. And the hydrogen required due to the stoich is 40. What is 40? You call the stoich, that's right. Okay. From the stoich, 1 mole acetylene, right, require 2 mole hydrogen. But we feed acetylene is 20, right? Acetylene, you can 20 multiplied by 2, we get 40. Because you have to calculate amount of feed based on the limiting reactant. This is limiting it acetylene, that's right. We feed acetylene is 20 because the amount of acetylene will be complete to the product or consume out or run out first. And then there are some hydrogen remain in the system. 20 mole of acetylene consumed, but from the stoich is 1 mole acetylene require 2 mole hydrogen. And then you can calculate the hydrogen requirement is 40 divided by 40. You get 0.25, and then you can multiply 100, you get percent excess. Right? The next, the fraction conversion or fractional conversion. This term we use right to consider how much or how many reactant consumed to the product. We calculate based on F equal to mole react divided by mole feed. It means the mole of limiting reactant react divided by mole of limiting reactant in the feed. And also you can calculate the fraction of unreactant. It is 1 minus F. And also you can calculate percentage conversion by multiply this equation by 100. By 100. And also, for example, right, if we have 20 mole per min of a reactant, it's fed to the reactor and the percentage conversion is 80%. Right, 80%. Okay, and then you can calculate mole react and mole unreact. What is the mole react? Initially, we have 20. Right? We have 20, and the reaction conversion or percentage conversion is 80. That means 0.8 convert. That's right. We get 16. That means it's 20 mole total. That's right. And it convert about 80%. Mean it 0.8 mole convert divided by 20 or divided by total, that's right, divided by total, sorry, we get 16. And another one is 4, that's right. Unreacted is 1 minus 0.8, we get 4. And total is 20 either. Initially and finally, input equal to output. Because initially is 20, finally it's also 20, but the finally it react to the product and unreact. React to product is 16, and 4 is unreact. The total is 20, see. For this example, we consider the reaction of acetylene react with hydrogen to produce ethane. Acetylene 1 mole acetylene react with 2 mole hydrogen, produce 1 mole ethane. Okay, we assume that 20 kilomole of acetylene, 50 kilomole of hydrogen, and 50 kilomole of ethane are fed into a bed reactor. And also, we support that after some time, 30 kilomole of hydrogen had react. The question is how much of each species will be present in the reactor at the moment. So we ask how much mole of acetylene, mole of hydrogen, mole of ethane remaining in the system after some time. That's right, some time. Okay, for this case, we know right, 30 mole of hydrogen react. 30 mole of hydrogen react. What does it mean? You know the hydrogen react is 30 mole hydrogen. Okay. How about the acetylene react? How about the acetylene react? Because you know, right? Okay. 1 mole acetylene requires 2 mole hydrogen. But for this, 2 mole hydrogen require 1 mole acetylene. Right. Okay. We get 30 multiplied by 1 divided by 2 hydrogen, it cancel. That's right. 30 mole hydrogen. Right. From the equation, we know that 2 mole hydrogen require 1 mole acetylene. And then you can calculate mole of acetylene that react. It is 15 mole of acetylene react. It's a 15 kilomole of acetylene react. Okay. And then from the problem statement, you know, right, 20 kilomole of acetylene feed to reactor. Feed to reactor, but it react at 15. What does it mean? 20 minus 15 is equal to 5 kilomole acetylene. Does it mean the acetylene that unreacted? Right? Reacted 15, unreacted 5 kilomole. That's right. How about ethane produce? Ethane produce. Okay, you can compare for this case. Also the same. 20 mole hydrogen from the reaction. That's right. 2 mole hydrogen require 1 mole ethane. Mole hydrogen, you get 15 also. That means that the amount of ethane produced is 15 mole of produce. Okay. It's produced 15, but also you know that the ethane feed in the reactor is 50. That's like the output or the final, that 15 plus 50, we get 65 kilomole of ethane in the present after the reaction, right? After the reaction. Okay, in conclusion, after the reaction, acetylene it remain in the system with 5 kilomole acetylene. How about hydrogen? I forgot to determine hydrogen. Hydrogen feed at 50, but hydrogen react at 30, that hydrogen remain in the 20, that's right. Feed is 50, react is 30. That means 50 minus 30, we get 20. Okay. Right. 5 kilomole acetylene remain in the system. 20 kilomole hydrogen remain in the system. And 65 kilomole of ethane remain in the system. That's right. Remain in the system with equal to 15 kilomole produced and 50 kilomole. That's right. 15 kilomole produced and 50 kilomole in the feed. And the next term is ethane operation. Before I definition of the reactant operation, we will consider first the reaction like previously shown. acetylene react with hydrogen and produce ethane. This equation is balanced already. If 2C kilomole of hydrogen react to it, the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen, we may follow the same reasoning and write that for hydrogen. And hydrogen means the final hydrogen or output hydrogen. That's right. The final, if we consider that process, the output we consider like the continuous process. Okay. The final or output hydrogen equal to mole of hydrogen in the initial step or the output. Sorry, in the input minus 2C. Minus 2C because the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen is -2. Right? And okay, for acetylene, the output or final acetylene equal to input or initially acetylene -1. That's not is stoi. That's not is -1C. And the last one, mole of ethane at the final step or output equal to the initially or the input +1C. 1 is the stoi number of the. That's right. Okay. For this case, we define nu I is the stoichiometric coefficient of the I species in the chemical reaction. That's right. For this case, it's negative for reactant and positive for product. That's for hydrogen is -2. This for reactant. Acetylene is -1 for reactant, and +1 for ethane. This product. That's right. For this case. Aside, new acetylene is -1, new hydrogen is -2, new ethane is +1. And also, if we define Ni0 or Ni.0, right, it's the mole for that process or molar folate for the continuous process of species I, we can write a general equation for this term. Right? For amount Ni, Ni means the final step. The final step equal to the initial step plus nu IC. Nu I is the stoichiometric coefficient. For the continuous process, that's right. Ni dot equal to Ni0 dot plus nu IC dot. This is the general equation. For this equation, we can define the extent of reaction is the C or C dot. It has the same unit of N or N dot. This is the extent of reaction. That's right. If we know feed quantity Ni0 or Ni.0 for I, we also know one of Ni or Ni. Then you can calculate C or C dot by application that equation. Okay. For example, right, if you consider like this reaction, nitrogen react with hydrogen to produce ammonia. This case, 1 mole nitrogen react with 3 mole hydrogen. Produce 2 mole ammonia and the reaction is balanced already. Okay, we assume that the feed to a continuous reactor consists of 100 mole per second of nitrogen, 300 mole per second of hydrogen, and 1 mole per second of argon. For this reaction, argon is inert with no reaction. No reaction. Okay. The chemical species composed of nitrogen, hydrogen, ammonia, we have 4 components. Okay, N dot nitrogen. The output nitrogen equal to input minus stoichiometric coefficient is -1 C dot. Right, C dot. And also for hydrogen, hydrogen output equal to input is 300 mole per second. -3 because the stoichiometric coefficient is -3 C dot. And ammonia, that's right, ammonia equal to input, there is no input of ammonia, that's right, equal to 0. Plus stoichiometric coefficient of ammonia is +2, that's right, and C dot. And how about argon? Argon input equal to output because there is no reaction on argon. It's an inner. You can use this. If you know output, you can calculate a chain of reaction for it. Okay. I'll give you an example, right? This example, right? Acrylonitrile, right, is produced in reaction of propylene, ammonia, and oxygen. This equation is balanced already. We react 1 mole propylene and 1 mole ammonia and 1.5 mole of oxygen to produce 1 mole acrylonitrile and 3 mole hydrogen. And this balance already. The feed contain 10% propylene, 12 mole percent ammonia, 28 mole percent air. Right? A fractional conversion is 30% of limiting reactant. Okay. On the basis of 100 mole of feed at a basis, determine the reactant limiting. What is the reactant limiting? What is the percentage excess? And calculate the amount of product gas constitute of 30% conversion. That's right, amount of this. The first step, you have to balance the equation. The equation balance already. That's right, for this case, balance already. Number of carbon left-hand side is the same. Number of hydrogen left-hand side is the same. Number of nitrogen left-hand side is the same. And oxygen left-hand side is the same. Okay, balance already. The basis is 100 mole of feed. The next step, you have to draw the flow chart. This is our process, reactor, something like this. We feed 100 mole. And you know 10 mole percent propylene is 0.1 mole propylene per total mole. 12 mole percent ammonia is 0.12 mole ammonia per total mole. And also we have 78% air, this is 0.78 mole air per mole total. For this case, mole air includes two components, oxygen and nitrogen. Include 21 mole percent oxygen is 0.21 oxygen per mole air. And 79% mole of nitrogen is 0.79 mole nitrogen per mole air. Okay. And the output, we don't know the amount of output. You have denoted by this term. N propylene, N ammonia, N oxygen, N nitrogen, N acrylonitrile, and N water. That's right. N is amount in term of mole. Okay, you draw the flow chart already. Next step, we have to calculate the limiting reactant. Okay. The first step, we have to calculate the amount of feed. Amount of propylene feed, that's right. N propylene zero. The feed propylene is 10% propylene. Amount of propylene is 0.1 mole propylene divided by mole total multiplied by 100. You get mole of propylene and also mole of ammonia 0.12 multiplied by 1 and then mole of oxygen. Mole of oxygen 0.21 multiplied by mole of air. Mole of air is 0.78 multiplied by 100. For this case in the reaction we need oxygen not air, but if normally in chemical process we feed air because air is cheaper than oxygen. Pure if you use pure oxygen we have to pay money. That's right, more and more compared to like to pay for air. Okay. Because the air in oxygen and nitrogen, you don't worry because the nitrogen is in no reaction for that case. No reaction for that. Okay. For this case, you can calculate mole of propylene in the feed is 10 mole because 0.1 multiplied by 100. Ammonia in the feed is 0.12 multiplied by 100. And then you calculate mole of oxygen. Mole of oxygen equal to 0.21 multiplied by mole of air. Mole of air is 0.78 multiplied by 100. This is the feed of propylene, ammonia, and oxygen. And then you calculate the ratio of this reactant and compare to the stoichiometric ratio. Okay, first we compare mole of ammonia and mole of propylene in the feed. Ammonia is 12, propylene is 10, you get 1.2. And then you compare ammonia with the propylene from the stoi. Ammonia 1, propylene 1 from the stoi is 1. This means that the ratio ammonia and propylene in the feed is greater than stoi. This means that ammonia is excess. Okay, the next ratio, we calculate the ratio of oxygen to propylene. Oxygen in the feed is 16.4. Propylene in the feed is 10, we get 1.64. And oxygen and propylene in the stoi is oxygen is 1.5. Propylene is 1, you get 1.5. It's also that's right, the feed is greater than stoi. The feed is greater than the stoi. Do you mean that oxygen is excess? Ammonia is excess, oxygen is excess. That means propylene is the limiting reactant. limiting lead. Conclusion, propylene is limiting lead. And now you answer already, the propylene is limiting excess. And then you calculate the percent excess. Right? Percent excess, you have to know the amount of feed and amount that required you to destroy. How much the amount of mole of ammonia required you to destroy? You have to calculate based on limiting rate, and limiting rate then is propylene. If propylene is 10, right? You have to calculate based on 10. You know 10 mole propylene in the feed and from the soil. 1 mole propylene require 1 mole ammonia. Right? 1 mole propylene require 1 mole ammonia. That you get 10 mole ammonia required due to the soil. In the feed, 10 mole propylene. And from the soil, 1 mole propylene, 1.5 mole oxygen. Right? You get 15 mole oxygen due to the soil. And also you can calculate percent excess. Percent excess is equal to mole of excess in the feed. Minus mole of excess required due to soil. Divided mole of excess required due to the soil. For this case, ammonia in the feed is 12. Ammonia due to the soil is 10. Divided by 10, you get 20% excess of ammonia. And also oxygen. Oxygen in the feed is 15.4. The soil is 15. And you get 9.3% excess. Okay, the answer, the second question, percent excess. Okay. The next, calculate the amount of gas composition in the product stream. This can be calculated based on fractional conversion. The fractional conversion in the problem statement is 30% conversion of propylene. 30% propylene conversion, you can calculate propylene unreacted design. The propylene unreacted is 70%. Propylene unreacted is 70%. That means you can calculate propylene output of propylene unreacted equal to unreacted fraction. That's right. 0.7 is the unreacted fraction of propylene. And then you multiply this by feed propylene. Feed propylene is 10. Right? Feed propylene is 10. 0.7 multiplied by 10, you get 7 mole propylene in the output stream. And then you refer to the extent of reaction by this equation. Operation. The output propylene equal to input propylene. That's right. Propylene is the reactant is minus volumetric coefficient of propylene C. The propylene output equal to propylene input is 10 mole. And the propylene in the reaction is 1 mole. This is minus 1. Minus 1 C. For this case, you know output. You can solve for C. And operation equal to T. And then you consider ammonia. Ammonia output equal to ammonia input interval. Ammonia, the soil is minus 1. Right? Soil coefficient minus 1. Minus 1 C. Minus 1 C. You substitute C. Calculate ammonia output. Then for oxygen output equal to oxygen input. Oxygen in the reaction is minus 1.5. Oxygen in reactant, that's right. Minus 1.5. You substitute C. You know NO2. And then mole of acrylonitrile, that's right. Acrylonitrile is product. Soil is positive 1. That's acrylonitrile equal to input at 1C, but there is no input. Input is 0. You get acrylonitrile equal to plus 1C. Substitute C, you get acrylonitrile. And nitrogen, there is no reaction of nitrogen. Input equal to output. There is no reaction, no external reaction. Output equal to input. And the last one, water. There is no input water, that's right. Output water equal to input. The water is product, sorry. The water is product. Right. So toy is 3. output equal to 3C. So QC, you get water. You get water. Okay. For this case, I talked to you the limiting reactant, excess reactant, percent conversion. And for next lecture, we talk to you the equilibrium chemical reaction in terms of multiple reaction. Yes, we talk about the G or something. Therefore, this lecture will stop now.